गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस एक्सरसाइज 9.3 क्वेश्चन 5th. हेयर यू कैन सी द स्टेटमेंट डी ई एफ आर रिस्पेक्टिवली द मिड पॉइंट्स ऑफ द साइड बी सी सी ए एंड ए बी. दिस इज द ट्रायंगल ए बी सी. डी ई एफ आर द मिड पॉइंट्स ऑफ बी सी सी ए एंड ए बी. दिस इज गिवन टू अस. सो हेयर वी विल टेक द मिड पॉइंट्स. शो दैट वी हैव टू प्रूव दीज थ्री पार्ट्स. सो गिवन, इन गिवन यू कैन राइट योर सेल्फ वट इज़ गिवन टू अस. डी ई एफ आर रिस्पेक्टिवली द मिड पॉइंट्स ऑफ ट्रैंगल बी सी सी ए ऑफ साइड्स बी सी सी ए एंड ए बी. सो दिस यू कैन राइट इन गिवन एंड टू प्रूव यू कैन राइट दिस थ्री पार्ट्स विच वी हैव टू प्रूव. नाउ प्रूफ फर्स्ट पार्ट. फर्स्टली वी विल प्रूव. नाउ यू कैन सी इन ट्रैंगल ए बी सी ई एंड एफ आर द मिड पॉइंट्स ऑफ ए सी एंड ए बी. सो बाई मिड पॉइंट थ्योरम वी कैन से दैट EF parallel to BC and EF is equal to half of BC. You have to write yourself midpoint theorem. Earlier I have told in questions what is the midpoint theorem. So write here by midpoint theorem, and you have to write the definition of midpoint theorem. You have to write yourself the definition of midpoint theorem. So direct here result we will write EF parallel to BC and EF is equal to half of BC. Now BD is equal to half of BC. Now you can write here BD is equal to half of BC. So because see here you can write BD is equal to half of BC because D is the midpoint of BC. So that if D is the midpoint of BC, we can say that BD is equal to half of BC. Here I have written the reason FE parallel to BD and FE is equal to BD. Now FE parallel to BC. If FE parallel to BC, then we can write FE parallel to BD also, because this is parallel to BC and BD is equal to half of BC. So we can write FE parallel to BD also, and FE is equal to BD. FE is equal to BD from these both. I have written here because FE is equal to half of BC and FD is equal to half of BC. This will be cancelled. It will left FE is equal to BD. So if we have written this two statement FE parallel to BD and FE is equal to half of BD, then we can say that if FE parallel to BD and FE is equal to half of BD, FE is equal to BD. Then we can say that if one pair of opposite sides equal and parallel, then we can say that that is parallelogram. So here we can say that BDEF is a parallelogram. Therefore sign it is BDEF is a parallelogram, because opposite sides are parallel and equal. Equal and parallel, you can write equal and parallel also, and I have shown with sign. So this was the first part. BDEF is a parallelogram, hence we proved it. Now second part, BDEF is a parallelogram. Just we proved only in first part, so we will write in second part BDEF is a parallelogram, and we will write just proved. Just proved means just now in first part we have proved what is it is the meaning of this. Now BDEF is a parallelogram. Similarly BDEF is a parallelogram. Similarly we can say that DCEF is also a parallelogram. DCEF is also a parallelogram. As we have proved BDEF is a parallelogram, likewise we can prove DCEF is also a parallelogram. No need to prove, just write here similarly. Similarly means it is understood as we have proved above BDEF, likewise only we have to prove DCEF, but no need to prove, just we can write similarly. This is the sign of similarly, that's why I have mentioned here similarly. You can use further this sign also, and you can write also as parallelogram sign we have used this. So this is similarly sign. Similarly DCF is also a parallelogram, and similarly DEAF. See, if you will see like this DEAF, this is also a parallelogram. So now DEAF is also a parallelogram. F and D are the midpoints. Here you can write. So here little I have mentioned otherwise no need to mention, we can write similarly DEF, DEAF is also a parallelogram, as we have proved BDEF is a parallelogram, we have said that F and D are the midpoints of AB and AC, likewise only in DEAF, DEAF, I have written DEAF, when we will prove DEAF is a parallelogram, then I have written F and D are the midpoints of AB and BC, means by that midpoint theorem only we have proved that TEAF is a parallelogram. Now otherwise no need to mention this, you can write just similarly in parallelogram DCEF, DE is a diagonal. Now you can see that these three parallelogram we proved, these are parallelogram DCEF, DEAF and BDEF, this is already proved, these three parallelogram we have proved, these are parallelogram. Now firstly we will take DCEF, any parallelogram you can take, I have taken DCEF. In parallelogram DCEF you can see DE is the diagonal. In this parallelogram it's visible to you, DE is a diagonal, and we have already done that diagonal divides the parallelogram into two equal parts, and that equal parts are triangle. So that only I have written similarly, in parallelogram DCEF, DE is a diagonal and diagonal divides a parallelogram into two equal parts, that parts are triangle. So we can write this triangle will be equal to this triangle, so this only I have written, this we will give equation first name. Now as I have done in this, similarly you can do in BDEF, which diagonal is visible to you, FD, so this will be equal to this, and now in this triangle DEAF, FE is the diagonal and this will be equal to this, so that only I have written. So that only I have written here. Similarly in parallelogram DEAF, FE is the diagonal, so this triangle area will be equal to this, second equation name give. Similarly in parallelogram BDEF, DF is the diagonal and diagonal divides the parallelogram into two equal triangles, then these will be equal, this we will give equation third from this picture. Now this triangle equal to this triangle, this angle equal to this triangle, this triangle equal to this triangle, we have written already. Now if you will see complete ABC triangle, you can see that ABC triangle is equal to, means ABC triangle, how it is made, or we can say ABC triangle equal to this triangle plus this triangle plus this triangle plus this triangle, that only I have written. Area of triangle ABC, area of AEF plus area of ABD, BDF, area of DEF and area of DCE, as I have shown earlier to you. Triangle ABC, DEF, we can write, now we have proved that, we have written that ABC area, this plus this plus this plus this, we have written. Now this triangle we can write DEF, and this triangle also we can write DEF, this triangle also we can write DEF. Why? Because we have proved in equation first, second, third, we have proved that this triangle is equal to this triangle, this triangle is equal to this triangle, this angle equal to this triangle. So in place of old triangle we can write triangle DEF, because in second part we have to prove that ABC and DEF relation, that's why in place of old triangle we have written DEF. So that only I have written here, ABC triangle plus we have written in place of old triangles DEF. You can write here by using first, second, third. So we can write here triangle ABC is equal to 4DEF. 4 will be taken here, this side, then it will left with us DEF is equal to 1/4 triangle ABC. Either write triangle, either write area. So in question it is written area, we can write this also and this also. So I have written, shift this side is this, and this is the second part, it is proved. Now third part, now you can see that third part, what we have to prove, area BDEF is equal to half of area ABC, this is the third part. So that only I have taken in parallelogram BDEF. Now BDEF we have to take, then I have taken BDEF, Now in BDEF, FD is the diagonal. So we can say that BDEF is equal to triangle DEF plus triangle BDF. You can see here BDEF. FD is the diagonal, so that this area of triangle is equal to this area of. So that only I have written here. But BDEF triangle DEF, or this also we can write DEF by using equation third. Now BDEF, this will be 2DEF, BDEF is equal to 2. Up now triangle DEF, what we have proved in equation 4th, we have proved area of DEF is equal to 1 by 4 area of ABC. So that we will put the value here, 2 to 4, it will be cancelled. So BDEF will be 1 by 2 area of ABC. This was only the third part, hence we have proved third part also. I am showing you here like this, we have proved complete sum, you can check, and half portion. This is starting. And this is the next page. In two pages we have proved first, second, third part. For question fourth, again we are revising question fourth today. Some students, they have done question fourth wrong, and some are saying that video is not clear of question fourth. That's why now you can see question is written here in the given figure ABC and ABD. ABC, ABD, it is given, it is. Are two triangles, these are two triangles on the same base AB. AB is the same base. If line segment CD is bisected by AB, CD is getting bisect by AB, means yahan CD bisect ho rahi hai, AB nahi, means it's like line is bisecting just CD. It is given to us CD is bisected by AB at O. Show that area of ABC, this triangle area we have to prove equal to this triangle area. Now some students are writing to DO, to CL. So see properly, it is A, B, C, D, O. So now solution, write yourself given. To prove, you can write yourself in proof. Firstly, we will take in triangle ADC, this triangle. Why we have taken this triangle? Because in this triangle, we can say that in this triangle, AO is the median. AO is median and OC is equal to OD, because it is given to us. We will take ADC. Some students written here ABC, but it is ADC. It is properly visible. It is ADC. In ADC, AO, it is median, or OC is equal to OD, it is given to us. So we can write in triangle ADC, OC is equal to OD. It is OC. It is AO. It is not AD, it is AO, AO. So AO is a median. Now we know that median divides a triangle into two equal parts. If median here in this triangle, if we suppose this is median, so this divides it into two equal parts. So now we can write this triangle area is equal to this triangle area. So we can say that AOC is equal to AOD. It is C, not L. It is C. And while sending pic, whenever you are writing in your notebook, send properly. Some students are sending it's visible D. Some students are writing O as D. Some students are writing C as L. So proper write. You can do work in your fair notebook by watching the video. Don't do any mistake in fair notebook, because further you have to revise from fair notebook. So firstly, as it is, which I am telling you, that understand once, twice, thrice. If once you will not understand, then see the video second time, then again, then do in fair notebook as it is work. Then you can revise in rough notebook, and when you know means when you will come to know that in rough notebook you revised properly, now you know properly, then you can send that fair notebook work to me, which you have done at first in fair notebook, then you can send. But do properly in fair notebook, don't do any mistake in fair notebook. So this question first, equation first we got, like ADC we have taken, likewise only do in BCD. So you will get second equation. If you will add first and second, you will get your result. Okay, thank you students.